We are glad to be here, me and my team. We will give you a small, this will be more of a demonstration session, and we'll give you some tips and some, you know, some things which are not available maybe, or some things that we do on a daily basis. And you will be able to also create tutorials, maybe for our project, maybe for your own use in your own colleges, okay, for your teaching learning purposes. So first of all, like sir already mentioned, you have to first decide what you want to teach, and you need to have your flow in place, what you're going to teach first, second, third, okay, in the order of learning has to be established right in the beginning, and then you start at the very first topic, okay. Always proceed from simple to complex, okay, which I'm sure as teachers you are already aware of. And you know, use simple language, okay. The motive is to help them to learn. It is not about how much we know, and it's not about creating tutorials on what I know and how much I know. It's more of, you know, teaching aid to the learners. So be at a very simple level, okay. I'm not saying you have to dilute your content. What I'm saying is teach in a simple manner, okay. Don't use flowery language or very technically difficult words, okay, because it doesn't help the learner, right. They are accessing your material because they don't understand the textbooks. So if you are going to replicate textbook language in your tutorials, it's not really going to help your learners, okay. So make it simple for them to understand. Now we have some procedures that we follow. One is we use screencasting. So screencasting is basically capturing anything that is demonstrable on a computer monitor. It can be a laptop, it can be a desktop, okay, it doesn't matter what machine you're using, but whatever is displayed on your monitor can be captured through software which are meant for screencasting. So we have screencasting software in both Linux and Windows, and also in Mac. So on Windows you can use a software called as CamStudio, CamStudio. It's free and open source. It has right now been bought over, but it's still available in free and open source version. Okay, so you can use it without having to buy it and without having to pay any license fees or anything of that sort. So look up for CamStudio and, you know, download it from the first available link. It will mostly be a TechSmith link, but you will find it on you know, most software providing services. On Linux, you can use something called as GTK, record my desktop. Okay, it's as simple as that, record my desktop. So if you look up for that, you will be able to find that. So I am on a Windows machine here, so I will just show you. So this is what the CamStudio recorder will look like. So once you download and install it on your system, this is what it will look like when you open it. There are very simple control buttons here, record, pause, and stop. Okay, very simple to operate. We also have a tutorial on this on our website. If you need additional help, you can go through that. So I will just do a very small, brief recording for you. This is the capture area. So whatever I demonstrate within this square will be captured, okay? And it also captures the narration. So say for example, I open something else, okay? I open something here, and okay, so right. And then I will just stop the recording, okay? Now, as soon as I finish my recording, this is what it will ask me for. It will always give you an AVI file as output, okay? CAM Studio will always give you an AVI file. So let me just save it with some name, test 1, 2, 3, and on my desktop so I can locate it easily. Okay, so whatever I showed you, whatever I did within that capture area is right there. Okay, now for recording your narration, you don't need any fancy equipments. You just need a headphone with a mic input, something like this. Okay, it's available at a very low cost, 200, 250, and you have a good recording system. So once I will just show you the file size of this. So you have an idea of, okay, so it's 348 MB and it's what, like hardly a minute, right? So if you were to create like a 10 minute long video, it's going to be huge, right? Yeah, it'll probably go into GBs. So you need to use something here, the icon that I'm moving here. This is one of the free available video converters. Okay.
Hit the recording in one shot, or we can pause it, resume it again.
You can pause. There is a pause button, right? And if you set the hotkeys for it, you can control it through your keyboard without actually having to go on the interface of CAM Studio.
Thank you.
So what we do is we tune it to Control S, which is our short key. So every time I need to pause, I just have to do a Control S and it will just pause the recording for that time. Then you can rearrange your screen, whatever else you want to, you know, you want to minimize some window, you want to open some window, you can do all of that and then do Control Pause again and it will start recording. Okay, it saves you a lot of editing time. Okay, so you need to use the pause feature very creatively. So like I said, coming back, this is one of the video converters which are available free of cost on the internet, okay? Mobile video converter, media converter, but there are many others, okay? This is just a sample. So now you've seen that my file was 300 odd MB, right? So now I will just add this file here. Okay, let me convert it to QuickTime. And add file. And here it is. Okay, without much loss of quality, I get a fairly good conversion. Now let us check the file size. Okay, 6.67. Okay, so 300 odd reduced to 6.67. So this is what you need to do if you're going to use CAM Studio. Because of AVI format, it's a huge file format. So without losing the quality of your video or your audio, you can convert it to a lighter file format, okay? Now, for those of you who are interested in learning about translation and dubbing, we have very simple procedures that we follow. The time script was displayed to you some time back by Kannan sir. So you must have noticed that there is a begin time for each sentence, okay? So every sentence, that is a begin time. So one sentence may be beginning at 3:45 and the next may be at 3:56 and the third may be at 4:02, okay? Now what it shows you is that between 3:45 and 3:56, you have how many seconds? You have 11 seconds, right? You have 11 seconds and you have this one sentence which in English takes 11 seconds to narrate, right? So when you're doing the translation, you have only 11 seconds to speak exactly the same thing in the local language, okay, in the language that you are translating. So that is where the time script really helps, okay? It helps you to know how much duration you have And what we suggest for translation in very, very briefly, what I can say is translate each sentence by sentence, okay, when you're doing the translation. So you have the exact duration with you for each sentence. And after you have translated that, you know, sometimes you find that I can't translate in that, you know, I need more words. So you can merge it with the next sentence if it is in continuum with whatever you're saying. So for example, if I'm saying click on save, okay, now type the file name and then click on the save button, okay, this is a one single activity that's happening, though it's narrated in three sentences. So if my time is I'm not able to fit in my words, okay, I can merge these three, and I need to communicate the action to the learner, okay, without losing the meaning of what is happening on the screen. I need to use my words very economically and very creatively, okay, so that I'm not losing the meaning of what is being said. So after you have done your translation and you have your script now, okay, so next thing is to give your voice for that, right? So we use a software called as Audacity. Works on any operating system. Audacity, Audacity. Okay, so this is what Audacity looks like. It works on Windows, it works on Linux and on Mac. Okay, so no problem. It has the same GUI, the same interface. So you just need to learn how it works. It doesn't matter which OS it is on. Okay, so again, very simple VCR controls here. This one is the record button. So when you want to record, you just click on that, okay, and you record something and then it is captured, okay. I do a pause and I can play it back. Okay, so like any audio software, it has got a left speaker and a right speaker, okay. You have a stereo mode, you have a solo mode or a mono mode also if you want to record, and it will bring down your file size, the audio file size. Okay, now once you've done this recording, okay, now this is what we call as the project file. Now here you can do a lot of manipulation with your audio. For example, if while you were recording, you know, somebody opened the door or something fell, and you don't want to do that recording all over again. Okay, there are some disturbances that happened. It's not superimposed on your voice. Okay, it has to be apart from your voice. See, if something falls or there's some noise and I am narrating, I can do nothing about it. But if it is in a portion of the audio where I'm not saying something, but it has got recorded, okay, then we definitely can remove it off. Okay, we can delete it off without having to re-record. Okay, so there are facilities in this software which allows you to remove noise, and it also allows us to amplify the sound. Now, when you play back and you find that the sound is much lower than what you expected it to be, okay, again, you feel exhausted or you just don't want to do it again. So you can just amplify the sound. Okay, so do you want to just show the... There are facilities which are inbuilt in the software itself for doing these simple things. It saves you time. So what we'll do now is we'll do a two sentence recording, okay, and we'll show you how to amplify it and how to remove background noise. So Sakina here will record two or three sentences.
So we have seen the timed script in English. Let me show you the timed script in the language, that is the Hindi language.
Yeah.
So we will record five sentences from these.
Okay, so notice that there is a time column on the left and the narration on the right. Okay, so she has translated it such that it is exactly in sync with the English sentence.
Fine, just open Audacity. So we have the record button there and we'll just start. LibreOffice Writer के spoken tutorial में आपका स्वागत है. इस ट्यूटोरियल में हम राइटर के बारे में सीखेंगे. राइटर में भिन्न टूलबार, जस्ट पॉज इट, डिस्प्ले, you can see that the audio is too low, so we can amplify the audio also. We just selected the audio, go to the effect menu and then click on amplify. It will automatically give you the value which is required for the audio to be amplified. Click on OK. You can see that the waves thing, the amplified audio. Just play it, Praveen.
इस राइटर के स्पोकन ट्यूटोरियल में आपका स्वागत है. इस ट्यूटोरियल में हम राइटर के बारे में सीखेंगे. राइटर में भिन्न टूलबार,
वी हैव सम बैकग्राउंड नॉइज आल्सो हियर, सो वी कैन रिमूव दैट डिस्टर्बेंस आल्सो. जस्ट सिलेक्ट अ पोर्शन वेयर यू फील दैट द डिस्टर्बेंस इज देयर एंड देन अगेन गो टू इफेक्ट. वी हैव ऑप्शन ऑफ नॉइज रिमूवल. Click on it, get noise profile, then select the audio again, go to effect, click on noise removal, okay, and we will have a better audio.
इस राइटर के स्पोकन ट्यूटोरियल में आपका स्वागत है. इस ट्यूटोरियल में हम राइटर के बारे में सीखेंगे. राइटर में
right, so we'll just see. The second sentence starts at the 10th second, right? Writer may bhin toolbar. So Praveen, just see if it started at 10th second.
No. So
then we have to split the audio. So for that we have Control I. We split. We use the time shift tool. We drag it and keep at the appropriate timing. So likewise, we split the audio according to the given time.
Okay.
Fine. Then we save the project file.
Now this is what we call as the project file. Okay, where you have cut the audio. You have slided it to wherever it is supposed to be. Okay, you have done all your amplification. You have done your noise removal. Okay, now this is your project file. So there are two saves that you have to do. One is you have to save your project file with all the modifications you have done and your original recording. And the second save that you do is you need to convert it into the format that you are actually going to use. Okay, it could be an MP3. By default, Audacity gives you an OGG format. Okay, now what we showed you here is we have split the audio, right? Now, if I have to do this over here, okay, now shift it back. Okay, supposing it's here and split it here. Split arbitrarily any point. Okay, now if I have to move this, it won't move. I need to create that gap for it to move, right? So we always start with the very last sentence. After we have finished our entire recording, we start with the very last sentence and we slide it into its appropriate time which we have noted earlier. And we always start from the back and we come to the beginning of the file. This is because you need to create that gap for you to slide it, right? Now I cannot slide the second clip because there is no space to slide it. I have to move the third clip, only then I can move the second clip. And only if I move the second clip will I have space to move the first clip. Okay, so it works in a reverse direction. You always start with the very last sentence that you want to slide into place, right? So this is your project file. So like I said, you have to save it twice.
Okay, now we have the project file.
Show the saved project file. Okay, there's an option called save project. You save it.
So we choose one location here, desktop, and click on save. So we have our sample .aup format, that is the Audacity format, and we also have one extra data file. So when we merge this audio with the video, the data file and the AUP file should be in one folder. Now we will finally export the audio in MP3 format. Just go to Audacity.
Going back to the project file. Okay, now just slide this. Slide the third clip somewhere and the second clip somewhere else. Okay, now assume that we have done our, we have time, we have placed it according to the time that we want. And now this is final, okay? We have done all the modifications that we want on this on this project file. So now is the time to export it into the final format for use.
So click on export. We have various formats for saving our audio file, OGG, MP3, WAV, right? So we'll be saving our audio file into MP3 format. Click on save. Click on OK. Just play that MP3.
राइटर के स्पोकन ट्यूटोरियल में आपका स्वागत है। इस ट्यूटोरियल में हम राइटर के बारे में सीखेंगे। राइटर में भिन्न टूलबार।
We have demonstrated along with a video clip.
Yes, now we will show you how to merge it with a video. Okay, like Kannan sir mentioned, the videos are created in English, right? The screencast and all of it is in English. So it also has an English narration. Okay, so we'll show you how you can extract the English voice from the video and then take the Hindi voice and put it into that same video. Okay, and you create a new video.
So just close this Audacity file.
Okay, so any doubts on the Audacity part? So because we are going to close this, yes ma'am.
During recording, we pause in between. So the different slab is created. So how to merge that two slabs?
Yes, yes, yes. We'll show you that. Okay. So ma'am, here is a very good question. That if you pause your recording or if you stop, it's you have created one track, one audio track. Now when you in the same project, you are continuing after some time. Okay, or you've taken a break. So. Okay, so now this time what it has done is it has created a second audio track. Okay, like she said, now they are on two different audio tracks. How do we get it into one? Because the final output, we need everything in place, right? So what we can do is very simple.
So we can just select the audio from the second track. Use the time shift tool. And we can just drag and keep on the first track. Now we can close the second track which doesn't have the audio.
Okay. This also means that after you have recorded everything and you realize you had to say one more sentence. Okay. You can go back to that same file, record that sentence and create the gap that you need, okay, wherever you need it, and you just place it over there. Okay. And you finally you have to get everything on the one single track.
Thank you, ma'am.
Sure. You want to say something?
One more point, as she said, I'll undo all the steps. Okay, I'm recording the first sentence. Something is going on, I'll pass it. If I want to record the second sentence, if I record, even the first audio track will start record in that. You can see that. The both will start recording, while whatever I'm speaking will record, and also what it plays here, that will also get record. So for that, select this tool and keep your cursor over here. Then if you press the record button, that will start from that particular point. So it won't overlap the previous recording and the fresh recording. And also while exporting, go to File, Export. You can see there is an option button. Here you can play with the settings for reducing the file size. For example, if you downloaded any audio songs from the online, you can see either 128 kbps or 320 kbps with the maximum file size. If you want to reduce your file size lesser, you can use any one of this by going down. And also you can choose as joint stereo or stereo. and you can click on OK. So once you exported, the file size will be lesser while compared to the previous thing. I'll click on cancel. It's okay. Now everyone saw how to record an English tutorial and how to record the dubbed audio. Now let's see how to merge both together. I am showing you an English video.
Hello and welcome to the spoken tutorial on printer connection.
Okay, this is the English video. The same video has been translated and dubbed into Tamil.
Desktop செல்வோம். Launcher barல் வலது பக்க மேல் முனையில் உள்ள.
It's okay. Now let's export this file. Go to file and export and click on options. As I already said, I reduce the file quality as 96 kbps to reduce the file size. Hope sir may mention that our tutorials are less weight. For example, rough we are thinking 1 minute video 1 MB. We are concentrating on that. So if you go with this kind of settings, our file size will get reduced. I already exported that file, so I'm not showing that again. So here's the file dubbed MP3 and I have the English video.
Play it. Play the dubbed MP3.
Printer இணைத்தல் குறித்த spoken tutorialக்கு நல்வரவு.
Okay. Now I played both the things. Now let's merge both the things. First step, what we have to do? I already have an English video. It's a kind of watching a dubbed movie. First, we have to remove the English audio from the video. For that, we are using some command line tools that is called FFmpeg. That will work on both, I mean, not both, all the ways.
All the ways.
Windows, Mac and Linux.
FFmpeg. There are two F. FFmpeg. Okay, so this basically will help you to extract audio from a file, from a video which already has an audio, and it will also help you to take another audio and merge it into a video file.
So you can go to the FFmpeg website and you can download the software based on your machine and you can install it, and it is a free and open source software. Important thing is it's a command line tool. In each OS, for example in Windows, Linux, Mac, there is a slight difference. For example, if I'm using the command in Linux, means I just have to type FFmpeg and space the options, whatever I want. Before that, I already organized my files into a particular folder. I'll go to that folder. So here you can see my dubbed MP3 and the English original, and along with the Audacity and data file. It's okay. First, I'll show how to do that in Mac. First, I want to remove the audio from the English video. So I type the path where the FFmpeg is installed on my machine. -i is an input file. With this option, we can input any number of input files, but we have to mention that -i for each and every time. So this is the file where my FFmpeg is there, -i for input option, and this is my English video. Next, I want to remove the audio and I want only the video. So I'll type -v codec, space copy, space -an. So this -v codec denotes the video codec, and copy will copy what the exact codec. We all know that MP4, QuickTime, MOV, WME, like that. But each and every file format have some particular video and audio codec. So this command will copy the same codec of the video. -an denotes to remove the audio from that video. Now I'll save that file as English-no-audio .mov, the same file extension. This will take some time. After that, you can see here the English-no-video. If I play that, I can't hear any volume. So with the help of this command, the audio is completely removed from the video. Now the next step is we have to merge our dubbed audio into this video. Let's go back to the command line. Let's type the command application -i. Our file is English-no-audio. So this contains only the English video. Next, I'm giving one more input, that is my dubbed MP3. Next, I'm copying both the video and audio codec. and my output file name, I give it as dubbed.mov. Again, it will take some time to merge both the thing together. I'll minimize. You can see a file which is created, dubbed.mov. Let's play that.
Printer இணைத்தல் குறித்த spoken tutorialக்கு நல்வரவு. இந்த tutorialல் நாம் கணினியுடன்.
So my dubbed audio and the video joined together. Okay, there are few changes if you are working on Linux or Windows. I'll show that. Consider this is my command. Okay, if I want to do the same command in Linux, I don't need to worry much. Just go back.
Excuse me, sir.
Oh, sir.
Sir, yes. I have one question. So as Linux is command-driven language, but in Windows, we do not have such platform for such kind of commands. So
I'm coming next to that.
We have the command line.
In Windows, we have DOS prompt, but all these Linux command like minus I, minus, these kind of options are not available. Or you have interface for Windows as well, in which we can convert.
FFmpeg will work on Windows with a minor change. I'll show you how to do that. You can open the command prompt.
Okay.
And do the same settings. So as I show that right now, I worked on Mac.
One more thing, sir.
What?
So is there is any graphical interface available in the software to do all kind of things, like if we go to menu bar and select remove voice, such facilities available or not in the software?
Okay, there is no proper GUI for that right now.
Yeah.
For example, few minutes before, Nancy ma'am showed that mobile media converter.
Yeah.
It is based on FFmpeg. I can show that. For example.
Well, as of now, there is no good
dub software. Okay.
I'm opening the mobile media converter application. Show package contents. You can see FFmpeg is inside that. So everything is based on that FFmpeg command line tool, but they are creating different GUIs. I'll prefer better go with the command line.
Okay.
So, okay, as I said that this is the command which work on Mac. If you want to do on Linux, just remove this. You don't need to mention where it is located. Mention FFmpeg space -i and the rest of the commands. So if you run this, it will work on Linux. If you are working on Windows, as I said, you have to mention the path. In most of the Windows, it may be in C:\ program files. In some machines, it may be in program file x86 or just program files and then /FFmpeg. So this is the only difference if you did on Windows, Linux or Mac. In Linux, we don't need to mention where the FFmpeg is located. By default, it will call. In Mac and Windows, we have to mention exactly the path which is installed. So that is the difference. Otherwise, the rest of the commands are same. You can run those things.
There is a video which is how to use Audacity and FFmpeg. It's on our website.
So what is the benefit to use of the FFmpeg if it is easily implemented in the Windows Movie Maker?
File size is one concern that we will have.
Easily through the file size, we can easily convert it.
One is file size, and the second is it's not open source, right? Windows is a proprietary operating system. You have to purchase Windows, right? It is not free and open source.
Allow you to convert these into various file formats. Like some are not available in Movie Maker.
Okay. File formats problem.
It has limited file formats into which you can convert.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.